so that I can share the presentation, right? Dr. Anuradha, you have to give that sharing facility to me, it seems. Am I audible?
You can do it, ma'am, now. You can share. You
can trying share. To share right now. Right now it is yes. coming. Yeah. Earlier it was not available. That facility was not available. Okay, yeah, very good afternoon to everyone, students and any faculties if they are there, I'm not sure. I'm here to discuss about the soft skills and communication skills to some extent, but my major focus is on the soft skills. And this presentation is divided into four parts basically. We'll start with the concept of soft skill, then we'll discuss the why soft skills are needed. Then it is what are the challenges to achieve it, and finally what are the improvement strategies. Once we know the challenges, we can just try to improve it in a way we are supposed to. So today we'll be touching only two topics: what is the concept and what is the need of the soft skill. So let's begin. Many of us are under impression that when we are good at soft skills, just a minute, huh? I'm just trying to. Okay. Is my presentation is visible to everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, very much.
Yes. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah. So looking at this slide, I'll request any of the students if he can explain this slide to me in 1 or 2 seconds. I'll not give much of time. Anybody if interested, he can just share his views on the slide, what this slide talks about.
Somebody wants to say something, please raise hand so that we can allow the person to talk.
Yeah. No one.
Sanjay Sonone is telling that the slide shows EQ and IQ of a person.
EQ and?
IQ.
IQ. Yes, he is correct. He is right. There is a balance shown between the brain and the heart. So many of us are under impression that soft skill is only playing a game by mind. If I am good at English, if I am soft spoken, or if I have everything, then I am good at soft skills. So it is not like that. That is what is this slide says. See, every time you have to have a balance between the two things, then only you are good at the, or you are the achiever. You can achieve something when you can keep the balance between these two things. So when I am working by mind or working by heart, no, don't forget that I have to apply the intelligence at the same time. That's, there should be a balance, and then only I can say that I am a good at soft skill as well as the hard skills. So both are equally important, and soft skills also has the intelligence involved. But there is a many senior people also feel many times that soft skill is only a presentation or only a communication. It's not like that. That is what this slide is trying to tell us. And in the beginning, I just forgot to mention, you must have heard my introduction. So I am from engineering background. So my most of the slides are, here I am saying job requirements. So this is first time I am giving presentation to doctors. So you can apply these slides to your profession or your requirements, your job profile. But as I know, soft skills are equally important for everyone as an individual's general topic. And you can always apply it to your field as well. So here I'm saying that when you have the soft skills and hard skills in place, you are meeting the job requirement, which makes you suitable for the particular job requirements in you. In your case, maybe you are working as a you know, you are in a teaching profession, or maybe you are attached to some hospital as a doctor, you are medical officer in any educational institute, I do not know. But it is ultimately a job or profile where you are going to perform and where you will be needing these two types of skills, and hard skills as well as the soft skills will make you suitable for, it will make you eligible for the job requirement. It will not ensure you the job, but it will make you the, make you eligible for that. That's what I'm trying to say. Right. So we'll start with the first part of the presentation, which is concept. What is soft skill is all about? Right. Here there are three parameters are shown. Somebody is reading, somebody is standing and reading, somebody is writing, somebody is showing the content, or somebody is just standing like that. So what is he doing? He's listening. So that we must understand that listening is also part of soft skills, which is most of us are unaware that listening is also part of the soft skill. How effectively I can listen is also the parameter which on which I judge on the soft skill front. Right. So one by one, we are trying. I'm just trying to highlight the parameters which comes under the soft skill. Many of us who know, who feels that only communication or only speaking good English or fluency in the language, not only English, any language for that matter, if I'm good at it, that means I'm good at soft skills. Not like that. There are many skills involved, many parameters involved, which we need to embrace in ourselves to claim that I am good at soft skills. So what are those skills and what are the indicative parameters for those? That is what I'm trying to highlight in this slide. So first thing which comes in mind is interpersonal skill. How one will know that you are good at interpersonal skills? The people who are very good at interpersonal skills, they are very good at delegation, if you observe. And it is applicable to everyone, right from housewives to any CEO of the organization. Anyone, it is applicable. The person who can delegate easily, you can immediately come, you can immediately say that it is good at interpersonal skills, dealing with each other. And it has to happen very automatically. The boss or senior can automatically delegate the things by using his authority. But that is not the part of soft skill. That is just the obligation. That is the burden. That is the limitations of the job or what you say, profile you handle. But interpersonal skill happens, makes it happen in a win-win situation, right? So one has to have this skill in himself so that soft skills can be demonstrated. Second thing comes, which is relationship, which is also equally important wherever you work in a team. It is important, and the person who is good at relationships, you will observe that he can solve the problem easily. See, problems can be different. It can be different for doctor. It can be different for engineer. It can be different for architects. For everybody, problem type is going to be different. But concept remains, if you are good at relationships, problem is solved easily. Third skill which comes under soft skill is verbal skill, which we generally, most of us are aware of, that we need to speak properly. I need to use proper language. I need to use good vocabulary. I should be good at English, basically. This is what is I need to, embrace myself or improve on so that I am good at soft skills. This is very much aware parameter of the soft skill. And many of the leaders we see, they are very good at communication, irrespective of language. Language doesn't come under this category. I have to be particularly telling this, highlighting this, that language doesn't come in this category. It is only verbal skill only talks about the how effectively you can speak. Any language it can be, right? And many of the leaders you must be observing, they are not good at English, but they speak very fluently whatever language they are trying to, in whatever language they are trying to communicate with the people. Okay, so these are the parameters. Right side is showing you the parameters on which you will be judged whether you are good at the parameters given at the left side, right? The person who is good at listening, his understanding level is better. Many times we feel somebody who is talking great, he is very good at understanding. It cannot be assured. You cannot be sure that he has understood the things. So active listening shows that the person who has understood, he is good listener. Right? Then comes when you are acceptable to the people, that means you have the team spirit. When you are acceptable to the people, whenever you are needed, people are preferring you. That means you are good you have the good team spirit. So team spirit also comes under soft skill. So these are, there are many parameters like this which you may be coming across first time. I do not know, but these are all just under soft skill category. Then comes time management, which I really do not have to tell the doctors how time plays a role in your life. That punctuality is something which shows that how good are you at time management. And punctuality is not only today attending the session at 4 o'clock. That is not the only parameter. There are n number of things where your casual approach is can be considered, you know, discounted, but still you are reaching at time. That shows your punctuality. Sometimes you give time to your friend and then reaching in time, that is also a part of time management. It is not only when there is somebody, you know, senior people has told me I have the pressure of attending the lecture and then I am attending at time. That is one thing. That is also not happening in many cases that I know, but that is part of the requirement, part of the job. But apart from that, in personal life also you have to have this punctuality in place so that you can be considered good at a soft skill, right? Then comes adaptability. You are emotional. Somebody said right in the beginning that EQ and IQ is shown balance. So emotional level, and it comes when you are more adaptable to the things. Emotionally, getting involved emotionally is one thing, and considering becoming empathetic is another thing. So here what I mean is that point is again that is also included, but emotional IQ, emotionally you have to be very strong, and you can observe people around you. The people who are emotionally very strong, they are very much adaptable to the changing situations. So they are also, it also comes under soft skill. That's what I'm trying to say. Then comes negotiation skills. Negotiation skills are in your field, you can compare it with the negotiation with the team members, negotiation with the, if you are working somewhere, a negotiation with your vendors, negotiation with your colleagues, negotiation with your subordinates. In a family also, we negotiate with our siblings, with our parents, with our kids. So this is also one of the parameter. How good you are at negotiation is also a judging parameter for the soft skill. You may be surprised to know these all parameters come under soft skill, right? Then presentation skill, that also we all know that it is a part of soft skill. Presentation skills are judged by if you make people understandable. You feel if you are presenting something and front person is understanding, even if you are not using good, as I said earlier, good language, good English, or maybe critical words, you are not using that, but still people are understanding, that means you are good at presentation. Right? It need not to be a very, very difficulty level should be high. It shouldn't be like that. It can be simple, but easy to understand. So that makes you good at presentation skills. And attire is a part of it, that we'll come to it later. But attire is also one of the presentation skill part, or maybe soft skill part, how you dress up yourself. When I go to temple, when I go to institute, when I am a student, when I am a teacher, when I am a doctor, as a doctor I am going somewhere, as an employer I am going, your attire should be according to that. That also speaks about your soft skill capability, right? Then comes body language. When I speak to someone senior, someone junior, someone of my age, wherever I am, my body language is indicating all the time how positive I am, and cleanliness is part of it, of course, and in your profession it is must, I know. So body language also talks about the soft skill capability of yours. Then comes empathetic we discussed earlier as well. Empathy and sympathy, a lot of confusion is there, but empathy is totally different by the sympathy. Sympathy is something which I feel for somebody, and empathy is something which I actually go to, means considering yourself in your front person's shoes and trying to resolve his problem. Sympathy is only there on the, it's only paper. I feel sympathetic for somebody. I feel bad for somebody. I feel sad for somebody. But I'm not in a position to help him, or I'm just leaving it like that. But empathy is beyond that. empathy is beyond that, and empathy is demonstrated when you are open for any change in your life. Because when you have to be empathetic, if you show empathy for someone, you have to be really open in your life. You should be ready for the change, right? Which is it sounds very simple, but when it comes to demonstration, it is very difficult to demonstrate, let me tell you, right? And finally, it's ethical is everywhere it is required. Ethics, I do not have to tell you what ethic means. Any field you are in, or in, and as an individual also, in personal life also, in your professional life, when you are treating your patients, or engineering, working somewhere, constructing building, wherever he is, but ethical, you should have ethics, and that earns respect. Giving respect and earning respect is part of ethics, and that also comes under soft skill. Very surprising, but it is part of ethical is part of soft skill. And finally, all about this, these are all soft skill parameters we are discussing. Knowledge is also soft skill parameter. Many people feel it comes under hard skill, so I do not have to really focus on the knowledge, but knowledge makes you confident and creative. When you have a thorough knowledge, then only you can be confidently presenting yourself somewhere. Am I right? So knowledge is also part of soft skill. It may not be your technical knowledge. Technical knowledge comes under hard skills, how to use it. But you should have the insight of the subject, so that other skills you can demonstrate. So that's why it is part of soft skill. So these are the various parameters which comes under soft skill, right? Any questions?
You can put your questions or queries in the chat box or in the question answer section.
I just forgot to mention in the beginning that you can give your response. You can ask your queries anytime during the session. No need to wait till the session gets over. In fact, I would like to answer it there itself.
Yes. In fact, we are getting introduced to the topic. So this is a kind of sensitization session for the students.
Yeah, it's a little fast, but as you said that there will be some more sessions when we can discuss this in detail. So I'm just making it a little fast.
Yes.
So I do not know, but it is very simple to understand what I believe. Yeah, it is very simple. But anyone, if he's having any question, he can raise his hand. He can directly talk to me. No need to write also. Otherwise, we can move ahead.
And what I feel that when we are talking about soft skills, all of you will be future dentists. You will be starting your practice sometime soon. So what madam is discussing about, as she said, that hard skills and soft skills. Hard skills are technical skills. So if we are learning dentistry and what we learn for 5 years, or if somebody is completing his PG, 8 years, we spend in an institution and we learn the technical skills. With these technical skills, we are entering our professional life. If we want to become successful in our professional life, we need to have a set of technical skills or hard skills and a set of soft skills. So these combined can take us to a future, successful future path. And what madam is describing right now is the soft skill sets which are required for us to become successful practitioners. And as a practitioner, I can very well relate. I hope the students will also be able to relate. If you think of yourself working in the clinical setup, and if you have all these skills, there are greater chances that you will be liked as a practitioner by the patients. Thanks, ma'am. We can proceed.
Yeah. So these are the, as you said, these are all, students will have to relate themselves where I'll be needing all these skills. But take it from me, irrespective of the profession, if irrespective of somebody is working, not working, he's sitting at home, all these skills are required as an individual. Each and every person needs these skills day to day life. You just consider your mother, if he is she's housewife, somebody is sitting at home, she also has to have these skills. Unless and until she has it, she cannot be successful in the era where she is working, you know. So this is how it is. But these various parameters comes under soft skills. That may be then input for everybody, that it's not only communication, not only language, not only presentation skills. Many aspects are there and all comes under soft skill category, right? So if I have to put it in a one word, all these parameters, if I have to use only one word, then it is approach, which we use day to day life. Every day we use this word. Your approach is not correct, your approach is wrong, your approach is negative, your approach is positive. So what is that approach? It's all this. It approaches everything of it, right? So we need to focus on our approach. Then what are the, if we have this good approach, if we embrace everything in ourselves of these parameters, then what happens? Right, let's see now why it is needed, why one has to work on soft skill. Okay, because anyway, when I get the degree, when I become a ME power system, be bachelor, be electrical, or you become dentist, you are going to be working somewhere or other. You are not going to sit at home, you will have your own setup like that. But then why it is really needed, right? Let's understand that. What are the benefits one get by learning soft skills? First thing happens in life is you can interact meaningfully. Every one of us talks to each other, but how many of us interact meaningfully? Meaningful interaction takes you to success, right? Then comes, we'll come to high self-respect at the end. That's the last statement of mine. Then comes, you become very fast at decision making. Any decision, when you have all these parameters set in your in you, then what happens, your decision making becomes faster, because this everything is going to make you confident, right? So decision making becomes faster, you become productive. Anyway, you were working earlier or you are going to work, but when I have all these qualities in me, naturally my productivity is going to be high, right? Then digitally proficient means what? When I get updated, because if I have to gain the confidence, if I have to be, I have to be creative, I have to be meaningful, I have to be good at presentation skill, I have to be good at verbal thing, then I have to have the, I have to use the updated knowledge, I have to use the updated technology, and that makes me proficient digitally as well, and which is the need of the today's time. Then I become updated, I become creative, I become confident, which is most important as far as medical field is concerned. I think confident is most important parameter. And then when I have all this, I win people, I win clients, I win my customers, I win my vendors, and for you, most importantly, I win my patients, because they are looking for these, what you say, these capabilities in a doctor, and that will make you win them. And it creates healthy work environment, because it's not only doctor and patient. You will have own setup, you will have assistants, you will have casuals, you will have, I do not know, you will be having so many people with you in one hospital. Then everything, it has to be win-win, no? It has to be that work environment should be high, and that is that you can improve, or you can have it only when you have all these parameters with you, all these qualities with you. And having all these in place, naturally, your self-respect is going to be high, which is the most important parameter to be successful in life. There is a circle which we'll discuss sometime later. This circle, how one reaches to high self-respect becomes makes you successful in life, and how to increase your self-respect. There are a number of things which you can follow, then you can increase your self-respect. And fit in employer's good culture. Need not to be you have your own company. You can be, you are part of some employer, you can be part of some educational institute, somewhere working, but there also you can bring that good culture, or if that is there already, you get fitted in that culture very soon, very fast. That's the advantage. And when I have everything, I am preferable for everyone. everybody will try to prefer me as a person, prefer me as a friend, prefer me as a doctor, prefer me as an colleague, prefer me as an employee, prefer me as an employer. So I become preferable everywhere, right? And then I can say, if I have to put all these parameter, all these gains, all these advantages in one word, then what it makes me, what it makes me, dynamic. Dynamic means the dynamics, everybody knows it's related to, this word is related to motion. It's a speed. Speed means speed of growth, speed of reaching people, speed of approach, speed of treatment, whatever it is, you have to relate it to your field. But I become dynamic. Many times we call somebody, that person is very dynamic, that doctor is very dynamic, this doctor is very dynamic, or whoever it is. So why what is that? That means he has all this capability. He may not be 100% at all the levels, he may be lagging in the 2-3 parameters, that's okay, but he has gained maximum of that. That is what I'm trying to say, right? So this is what was planned for today, because it was 30 minute session was what I was told. So should we go ahead or should we stop here, doctor?
Hello, I don't know if Pustake sir is hearing you. It made a wonderful session. I think introduction to soft skills, this is something that every individual needs, and you have done an excellent job of touching upon the qualities that are required when we say that, you know, somebody has soft skills. So mm-hmm. I think you know, in the end, when you were trying to say that, you know, the person needs to be dynamic, so the person needs to have that kind of flexibility and adaptability, you know, so the situations may change. This may not be something that is, you know, within your comfort zone. Sometimes you need to push yourself beyond your comfort zone, so you have to be prepared for it. So I think having all those soft skills helps a person in every stage of his career. And as you said, it's not just if you are having a career, in every field of life, soft skills are important. And I think that's what your talk aimed to achieve. And it was a good sensitization to the topics and the various headings. I think many of us did not even know what are the things that would come under soft skills. All of us have heard the word soft skills, but not many would have known what are the various parameters, and not many would have tried to find out. So I think you did an excellent job by introducing us to soft skills.
Thank you.
Pustake sir?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
What I was thinking, Pustake sir, that challenges, yes, and improvement strategy we can discuss tomorrow. If we do not have time today, I am ready to discuss today also. We can finish it off. Okay. But as you say, I mean, if you want to continue itself, we can complete challenges and improvement strategy, because all these parameters looks very simple. Isme kya hai? Ye to anybody can adapt, but it is not that simple. There are challenges to each and every parameter, and what are those challenges? And how to improve on that? That I want to discuss with the students.
I think we can discuss it right away also.
Is it?
Yes. Yes. No issues. Yes.
Fine. So we have, so far we have discussed what is soft skill, what is the concept of soft skill. Then we have discussed why it is needed. What are the benefits I'm going to get when, if I am good at soft skill? And then now we are coming to the point, what are the challenges? People are trying to put the things in place, but they are not able to. So what are those challenges I face when I do this, when I'm trying to gain these parameters? First, I lag in willingness. If you have willingness, you are going to achieve it. Take it from me. If I do not have the willingness, I cannot do it. Except that I need to improve. I want to embrace these qualities in me. I want these parameters in me. Then only you can, right? I'll just tell you what this UCIC and all means. But first, let us go through the parameters. Then I'm not aware only. How my willingness will come? Well, because I'm not aware this type of qualities are required in life. I am not introduced to it. So you should thank Dr. Pustake or your college that they are calling somebody and making you aware that these are the parameters where you are going to judge somewhere, or maybe you are going to live a happy life with all these parameters with you, right? So that awareness is lagging. Then discipline is not in place. I am willing to do it. I am aware also, but I have no discipline. And discipline is something is not like कल मेरा इंटरव्यू होता आज डिसिप्लिन का बुक में पढ़ के जाऊंगा. इट इज नॉट लाइक दैट. इट हैज टू बी प्रैक्टिस्ड. डिसिप्लिन हैज टू बी प्रैक्टिस्ड डे टू डे. देन सम पीपल आर विलिंग टू डू इट, अवेयर, दे आर डिसिप्लिन्ड आल्सो, बट दे डू नॉट हैव टाइम. दैट इज कैन बी इशू. दैट इज वन ऑफ द चैलेंजेस मेनी पीपल फेस. अरे मुझे करना है बट आई हैव नो टाइम टू डू इट, राइट. देन सम पीपल लैक इन एबिलिटीज, राइट. दे डू नॉट हैव द एबिलिटी टू डू दैट. कॉन्फिडेंस इज वेरी लो. There is no support system. I want to do it, but nobody is supporting me. My parents are not supporting me. That can be one of the reasons that I am not able to achieve it. Guidance is not there. And last but not the least, finance. I have no finance to get the money, right? So let's quickly understand what this UCIC, CIC and CC means. There are four quadrants. UCIC means what? Unconscious, incompetent. Means what? There is, I am in a zone where I am not aware, or I do not know what I want to do, and I am not competent to do that. So let's say anything like driving a car maybe, or maybe cooking. I do not know, I am not competent to do the work. I am not even aware that I want to do it. That is the first zone I am in. So you have to decide where you want to be, in which quadrant you want to be. Then the stage comes where you become conscious. You become conscious that you get the feeling that, yes, I should learn this. I should learn a car. I should learn driving. But you are incompetent to do that. So moving from first zone to second zone is very easy. You have to find out that what I have to do and become conscious at least. Yes, I have to do it. I have to get these parameters in. I have to learn all these things. That is the first stage. You can move from first to second stage easily. Where in second quadrant, you are incompetent to do that. You cannot drive a car, but you are willing to do it. Then comes a quadrant where you are conscious and competent. You start learning the things. You start learning the things. You are and you become competent. You have learned to drive a car. You have started driving. But you're still conscious. Means here conscious word is little bit differently used, that I have learned driving. I'm now driving a car, but while driving a car, I cannot listen to music. I cannot talk to the person sitting next to me. I cannot do anything. I have to just focus on the driving. I'm so conscious in that because I have learned it newly, or maybe I am not expert till that much expert to do it in a unconscious mode. Are you getting my point? So again, quadrant to third quadrant is very challenging. It takes huge efforts from incompetent to competent. And again, from third quadrant to fourth quadrant, when you will go, you will not know yourself only. You become unconscious competent. Means what? I take a key, I sit in a car, I go to the place where I want to go, but I do not know which gear I used. I do not know. I am just talking to the people, listening to the music I want to, interesting music I am listening to. I really do not know which road I am taking. Sometimes I just go to the place where I do not want to go, where every day I am going. I am every day going to college, and today I am going to a friend's place. But with the presence of daily practice, maybe I am just reaching to the college, and once I reach to the college, I come to know, I have come to college, but I didn't want to come here. I wanted to go to my friend's place. Because you are in unconscious competent mode, you have become so much competent. You have become so much competent. So unconsciously, you are doing the jobs, like speaking various languages, maybe cooking. Our mother and all, they do not discuss recipes and all. They watch TV. They prepare food at a time because they are in unconscious. Competence, you have to list and you have to see that in which mode I am in right now. Am I in first quadrant? Am I in second? Am I in third or fourth? Where I am? Right? Some qualities like giving gullies and all, we are always in the UCC mode if you see. We do not have to think. It comes automatically. Some people, even if they are happy, they give gullies. Even if they are sad, they give gullies because they are unconsciously competent in that job. So if I want to have that willingness, I have to be aware, I want to follow, I want to become disciplined man. If I am too very good at time management, I have to increase my ability level. then I have to see that in which quadrant I am right now and how to move in the second quadrant. That you have to see. Right? So this is what is the UCIC, CIC and CC means. So this is the basic of working model of anything for that matter. Here we are discussing soft skills, various parameters we are discussing, but anything you take in day-to-day life, you can put it in this zone and you can just try to work out whatever you want to learn. So these are the various difficulties or challenges we have discussed to achieve that. Then how to improve it? What can be the improvement strategies? So there is one way of, there are n number of ways to do that. In every individual can adopt a very different solutions it can be. But from me, I can give you 4-5. Like one is which I do for myself many times. That is one strategy which is called as a 5W1H. Like if I want to improve on something, or if I have to do some work, I have to complete some work, then I ask myself, why am I doing it? Who is going to do that? Where am I going to do that? What it will give me, and when I have to do it? And how am I going to do that? If I have answers for all these questions, then I can achieve that. Then only I can achieve it. If it is not fitting in this model, that means it is not of any use to me right now. I'll keep it aside and I'll go ahead. So if I want to address any of the parameters or any of the qualities for presentation skills. Who is going to teach me? Who is the source? Where I can practice it? What change it will bring in me? And when am I supposed to do it? Right now, when I am in the first year, second year, third year, after getting the degree or after my post graduation, or when? That you have to decide. And then finally, how am I going to achieve it? If it is needing some, costing some money for it, then from where am I going to arrange it like that? So this is the one strategy you can have to address the issue. Then you can choose your surroundings. These are some parameters, tricks or some points I am trying to share, which you can adapt and try to understand, try to follow, I mean. Okay, so what you can do, you can choose your company, be in a company which are good at those qualities you are looking for. But generally our tendency as a human being is, we generally prefer a mob, we prefer a friend who is not better than us, who is lower than us in a quality we are looking for, because we want to feel better. If somebody is not good at speaking, we will try to make friendship with him because you should look better, but there where you are making mistake. You have to choose a company which is better than you. You have to be in a company which has that qualities which you are looking for. Otherwise, how will you gain it? How will you learn it? You have to learn it from somebody. So choose your surroundings company like that, right? Choose your mentor, which is very, very, very important. Mujhe hi samajhta hai, main hi sabse zyada sehna hu, aisa nahi hai. You have to choose your mentor. Who can be your uncle? It can be your elder brother, elder sister, your father, your friend, friend's father, friend's uncle, whoever it is, lady, male, female, anybody it can be. It shouldn't be, there shouldn't be any botheration. It should be really. I want to learn good English, say, or I want to learn Germany or whatever it is. This is the person who is very good at it. I should follow him. I should make him as my mentor. Aim to hear. When you when you communicate with somebody, aim to hear. Generally, we aim to talk. So aim to hear what foreign person is trying to tell. Then only you will get some inputs. Otherwise, discussion will end up talking, you talking, and nothing is gained at the end of the session. It shouldn't be heard also. When you are hearing to someone, you have to ensure that your point is also taken into consideration. What you wanted to say is also heard by someone. Otherwise, again, it is not win-win. No, it is win-lose. Somebody is talking. Hope you understand the concept win-win and win-lose. Win-win means two people are talking to each other, and at the end of the discussion, at the end of the conversation, everybody is getting the feeling of winning. That doesn't mean all points were accepted. That means if it's win-lose, if somebody's 100% points are accepted and somebody's not a single point is accepted, that means it is win-lose. It is not win-win. Win-win means both the parties should feel that, okay, my point was not accepted, but discussion was convincing. I could get some takeaways. I could get some inputs like that. So that is what is the, that should, you should look for any conversation you have with somebody. Then keep observing people, keep observing good people, somebody talking, somebody standing. Even when you, in my college, I remember we used to call faculties to give presentation. Student used to chat, but I used to tell them, just observe that how he starts, where he is keeping his whatever belongings, how he is trying to give examples, what type of videos he is using, what type of dress up he is into, what attire he is in. That you can observe, always you can do that. So keep observing people. Plan for yourself. You cannot succeed if you do not have plan, right? Then you have to read. Reading means what? Not the current, what you say, Bollywood film, Bollywood matters and all. You have to read some current affairs, past, you know, you should read history as well and read the topics, read the book which are relevant to your, not medical or like that, whatever you are looking for. If you are looking for the positivity or creative thinking, problem solving. So there are n number of books are available. You can just try to get it and read it. Keep reading. Reading will never go west. You have to write also. Whatever you learn, you have to write for yourself, because today something you read and after 8 days you forget. You tend to forget. So you keep writing. It will be useful for you. If not you, somebody else can use it. So keep writing. And that gives you insight, a different insight. Writing is also equally important. Then you have to have patience when you are discussing, you are presenting, you are dealing with some transaction, you are giving lecture or whatever it is, but you have to have patience for everything. Maintain your character. That one need not to explain in detail, but what you know what I mean when I say character. Positive character is, good character is very much important. It boosts your self-respect. That's it. Be positive. You have to embrace positivity. Look positive things in each and every aspects of life. Work on your body language. When you talking to your mother, when you are talking to your father, they are the best people to start with for the body language, because they are the most they are the people where we are most casual with, right? Mainly when we talk to our mother, we give least importance to that relation when we talk to our family members. So start from there. Start from there, try to see your gestures, how you are talking, softly, like that. So that when, if you can perform there, I am sure you can perform in on the office floor, wherever you are, in the marketing, sales, as a doctor, as an engineer, architect, whatever it is, CA, you will demonstrate the good body language, because you are good at your family place. Then eye to eye contact, not only for presentation skills, you will have another lecture for that. There you will come across this concept, what is eye to eye contact. But anytime, anywhere, when you are talking to somebody, when you are talking to a patient, when you are talking to your teacher for that matter, you have to have the eye contact. That means what I'm trying to highlight here, eye to eye contact means when you are talking to somebody, try to look at his face. How will you feel when you are talking to someone and that person is talking to, looking at your hands, looking at your legs? It doesn't, irrespective of gender, it doesn't give good impression. When you are speaking to someone, where you are looking, where you are focusing, that is very, very, very important. That gives a test of your personality, what kind of person you are. So that is why it is important. So try to follow this. Those people some people are not intentionally doing it. It's their habit, but they have to work on it, what I will say. Try to practice public speaking, not in public maybe, but in your small groups of four, five students, six students, you can have a session where you can discuss your topics and you have to practice it. And finally, there was one big challenge which we discussed in the last slide, that finance, from where finance will come. I want to do many things, but my parents are not sponsoring. They are not giving money to me. Then how can I earn money? So earn by saving. Save. You keep saving. As a student, at least minimum what I can do, I can save to some extent. Keep saving. When you save, that is one of the methods of the getting the finance. It may not fulfill 100% of the requirement. It will be little less, but it will add to the contribution. And if you have your saving with you, somebody will definitely try to help you. You can say, I need 5,000 rupees, but I have 2,000 with me. I am sure your parents will give you 3,000. But every time if you keep demanding the money, parents will also feel that, or whoever is your sponsor, he will feel that he is only asking for the money. But then you have to also demonstrate by saving. See, I have saved this much in my from my pocket money. And how to save, that you have to decide. Where you want to save, that you have to decide. You will go by walk or you will not eat snacks one day. I don't know that. That you have to decide. You have to check your lifestyle. You have to say, check that. But you have to earn by saving, right? Money earned, money saved is money earned, finally, right? Then practice. Some of the practice sessions, like when I was working somewhere, or many of my colleagues, we always used to feel that, why only me? Or in classroom also, you must be feeling, many of the students feel, a teacher, every time he tells or she tells, work for me only. She answers questions to me only. And we get upset with that. Even in the family, there are 4 or 5 siblings. One person will always feel that mother is giving work to me only. Why not others? And that when that question comes to your mind, only me. You have to convince yourself by giving this answer. Yes, I am preferred because I am something different. There are 60 students in the class, but teacher is asking question to me only, or she is giving some assignment to me only. Why? Because I am capable of doing that. I am capable. I'm better than anyone else. I can do it in a better way than anyone else. That's why I am preferred. And you answer this question like this, I am sure you will gain a different type of confidence you will have. And you will learn so many things in a process. So many things, I'm telling you. In fact, if somebody is not giving you the work, you should tell and go and tell that, yes, I want to do this. Please give this work to me, right? Second is practice positive self-talk. Positive self-talk means, yes, I can do it. Many of us, when we want to do something, our first thought comes in mind, if somebody else do it, it is better. Try to push it on the somebody else. Why? I won't be able to. I'm not good at English. I'm not good at speaking. My voice is very low. My this, my that. I have that problem. No, you can do it. Start with a positive self-talk for anything. A challenge come to you, positive self-talk is must. You should start with the positive self. Positive self-talk makes you, when your self-talk is positive, you become, your self-respect goes high. And that takes you to success. It's a circle, basically. And your efforts are also, according to your self-talk. Your self-talk is low, your efforts are low. If your self-talk is high, your efforts are high. And efforts decide that how you are going to achieve the success, right? So there are many ways how to have the self-talk. We'll come to it. Let's finish off this. Then, as we have already discussed, that what is unconscious competency. So you try to be in a zone 4, quadrant 4 for good behavior. Anything happens in life, I am going to be just competent. Nothing bad will come from me. I will not get angry or whatever it is. Whatever you have decided, you have to list down all your areas or all the qualities. I will not say bad qualities, but some non-qualities where you want to improve on, and try to come to the unconscious competency zone so that your self-respect boosts up. Okay, be in a low urgent, high important zone, which is again one more strategy to decide to prioritize your work. There are 4 zones which talks about the urgency and importance, which I will not go into much of details, but I'll just tell you what it means. It's urgent and important. You have to have there are a number of things to do, and you are confused that which thing I should address first. Then you have to categorize basically what is urgent and what is important. So high urgent, high important. Some of the works maybe it is high urgent, high important. That has to be firstly addressed. Then comes low urgent, but high important. Low urgent, low important, and finally high urgent, low important. So throughout your life, you should have the strategy that none of my work will come in this category: high urgent, low high urgent, low important. It should not go in that. Urgency should not happen. You should ask which category: low urgent, lower important. But you have to have the, you have to do the things at time. Like, you know, assignments are given. You have to submit it today, tomorrow, maybe after 1 month you have to submit it. But what you students do, they always try to keep it at the end. They convert it into high urgent. It is low important that time because it is not going to give any benefit to you when you are copying from someone. So it is low important in your life, but it has become high urgent and worst zone you will work in. I mean, so try to categorize and try to work in the low urgent, low important, or low urgent, high important zones. These two zones are comfortable. You have to be working in these two quadrants only. And that builds your attitude. When you practice all these things, right, automatically attitude becomes like that. And your attitude decides that how much efforts you are going to apply for the task given to you. Any task, it can be improving your skill, presenting something, whatever related to your field, you can think of anything, any operation, anything. But that decides, your attitude decides how much effort you are going to put in. And attitude builds on the parameters what we discussed earlier. So you have to decide that where you lag in and you have to work on that. So there are some pictures, like many of you will be working somewhere. So there are some do's and don'ts, like how you should have the attire when you go for an interview. There are two ladies shown. This is self-explanatory. This slide is self-explanatory, if you see. How should you dress up when you go for an interview? Right? See. One in a casual wear, one in a formal wear. So what should be the attire when you go for an interview? Both are in formals, but if you see one person with the closed, folded cufflinks and with the check shirt, this is a plain one. So this is preferable when you go for an interview. This is general. You can just have the different, I do not know, in your profession what is, but mostly this is applicable to all the profession, what I feel. See the facial expression when you go for an interview, when you are talking to someone, see the facial expressions. This is all part of soft skill. Somebody is listening to the lecture. Both are wrong. None of them is correct or appropriate. When you are presenting something, you are position of the hands, closed or open, it has to be open always. Two people have come to discuss something or to meet each other and they are busy in their mobiles, which is also not a good soft skill practice. Shaking hand with somebody, again, irrespective of gender. Front person can be a lady, it can be a gents, whoever it is. You have to have the firm handshake. You can just make out the difference between the two handshakes. What does it mean? One person is talking, other one is listening, but there is all chaos. The communication is not clear. What he is not understanding what he is trying to say. So one must work on that. There is a meeting going on. Somebody got a call from somebody and there itself that person is discussing. Other two are just watching what a third person is trying to talk to somebody else outside the world of meeting. Just see. This is also bad practice. If you get a call, you should leave the meeting, you should go somewhere. Fine. Firstly, though, you have to disconnect. You have to send a message that I'm in a meeting, cannot attend your call. If you attend it also, you have to go outside, far from that place. What is it? People are gossiping in the office, which is also not a good practice. Gossiping is not appreciated anywhere. Here females are shown, but take it from me, I have worked with an industry for 14 years. Males equally gossips, and which is also not a good practice. So you don't take the message like only gossiping is not allowed for ladies. It is not allowed for gents as well. People are waiting outside for the interview. See the expressions. You are judged on this. when you go for an interview. Maybe they are tired, they have been called in the morning until afternoon, they are not called for the meeting, but you have to maintain that. Body language has to be maintained. Person is giving presentation, but he is not comfortable. Superior, senior is explaining something, one person is biting his nails. The way you stand is also important. Last one is correct posture. This is positive slide. Both the people are looking at the face of each other and with a smiling face, trying to deal with some foreign person with a open mind. See, talking to colleagues, he is maybe, you know, annoyed, angry, we do not know. But the way he is putting his things forward is not correct. This is again good practice. So this is what it is. When we want to be successful in a team, each and every alphabet has to be in place. Otherwise, you are out of the team. Okay, there are some tips given, which are also many important aspects of soft skill. Like when you introduce yourself, you have to smile truly, offer a firm handshake, greet politely. Then good postures, you have to walk tall, sit tall, stand tall, sit at the front edge of the chair. Just don't lean it like, you know, you have come to take an interview. It's not like that. Should not give that impression. Then you have to have the effective communication, which is the combination of understanding the things you are. When you are answering the questions in the interview, maybe you are going for an interview, what are the parameters on which you are judged whether you are good at communication? So your understanding level, your knowledge level, and how you have the positive relation. Maybe positive relationships you will not be able to demonstrate there itself, but it reflects when you speak, when you refer something, when you give some examples like that. It reflects in your speech. So that is also a part of soft skill. Then these are some tips when you go for an interview, how to read the interviewer's language. Like if somebody is crossed arms or leaning away from you, like somebody who is taking your interview and he's leaning away, so it shows that he's at discomfort. You have to give some space. His fiddling or loss of eye contact, he's trying to, you know, looking at something else, he's not looking at your face. That means he's not interested what you are talking in. You have to wrap up your session fast. Like frowning or pursing lips means he is not in agreement what you are saying. You have to read the facial expression. Just don't continue with your things. If some foreign person is not in the mood of, or he's not accepting, his face is showing that he is not accepting, he's feeling that you are lying or something like that. So you have to ask that, do you need any clarification? You have to clarify, you have to give more, you have to reduce his, clear his confusion. So you have to read, just don't try to push your, whatever you are trying to say, just don't try to push it. Try to read the interviewer's language. Raising eyebrows or widening eyes means he is surprised to know something, right? So you have to, means he is not believing what you are saying. So you have to prove it with the facts and figures. Rubbing fingers or crossing, uncrossing legs, again discomfort, is impatient, is frustrated with you. So again, check you are providing the info they are looking for. Means what? Whatever is asked, you have to be very specific to the question. Just don't try to be boring. Like he's asking something and you are giving some history which is not required, which is not important for him right now. So these are some warning signs when you are going for the interview. These are all parameters. These are all things which comes under soft skills. I don't know how many of you are final year students or how many are PGU or how many of you are going to face this situation, but it is important and many of you may be needing it. So when we have all these things in place, when we have all the soft skill parameters in place, we can say that we have got the key to success. It's like that. And that will make you different than others and you become wanted. That is what this slide trying to explain, give a message, I mean. All right, There are few concepts came in between which I did not purposely elaborate because it will be too much for the session. But if in future we will be having any other session, we'll definitely try to see each and every concept in detail, right? Each and every parameter in detail, that how one can work towards it to achieve that. Because soft skill is very broad, what you say, concept. It's not something which you can be learned in a day or 2 hour session. And it is a matter of practice. Thus, log bhi aake padhayenge, to bhi it is a matter of practice. It is not only learning, listening to somebody. One has to practice it. It's like that. So I end it here. If any questions are there, I can take it.
Yes, students. If there are any queries, any questions, anything additional that you want to know, please let us know.
Yes. Yeah.
You can put it in chat box. You can ask here. There is one question, madam. How social media is affecting the soft skills these days?
Social media is affecting.
From Preetal Jadhav. Uh-huh. How social media is affecting the soft skills? Can you explain, Preetal? Can you explain the question a little more?
Because I have got some message, but I let her explain in detail what exactly she is looking for.
We can make you talk also if you're ready.
Yeah, let her speak.
Preetal, we have enabled you to speak. You can speak. Preetal, you can speak, I think.
Yes, sir. Sir, these days people put themselves in a way that we don't understand sometimes, or we don't get what they're trying to say. So how soft skills are developing it?
Means you want to understand something which is not, means you are not able to understand what somebody is trying to say, right?
Not in that way, but how you can improve your soft skills on social media, like how you can express yourself using your soft.
You want to be ask that how you can be effective in communication on the social media.
Yes, that too, okay. And also how people couldn't make you what should I say? Misunderstand you.
See,
with your behavior.
Preetal, I got your question. Okay. But something which is out of your control. See, you cannot make. See, you can use. First thing is you can use a simple language. And there shouldn't be. When you are reading somebody else's post, always don't write in between the lines. That is the first rule when you read something. जनरली अवर टेंडेंसी इज इसको शायद ऐसा बोलना है तो ऐसा लिखा है नो वॉट इज रिटन यू रीड इट एंड गेट द मैसेज एंड वी आर गुड एट लैंग्वेजेस इफ इट इज रिटन इन मराठी यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट ही इज ट्राइंग टू से इफ इज रिटन इन इंग्लिश यू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज ट्राइंग टू से दैट इज वॉट इज द मीनिंग डोंट ट्राई टू यू नो मेक आउट सम मीनिंग विच इज नॉट मेंशन इन द मैसेज दैट क्रिएट्स अ प्रॉब्लम that creates a problem, and people want you to do that. So, defend them by not reading it. And when you write something, you also follow the same principle that what I am trying to say, I will put in a simple words. I will put it in a simple words, which message I want to convey, that message I will write. You are trying to ask that how to write something which is not misunderstood by someone.
That too, and also, as you have said, we are portraying ourselves to someone, obviously, on social media or any other platform. We are using our soft skills. It is also important for us to maintain that our own portraying thing on social media too, as general how we are.
See, let me give you one principle or one theory. I don't know whether it will answer your question or not. There is one theory, like what I want to say is a talk. Let's say my talk. Okay. So there is first theory says that self talk is equal to talk. Means what? If you want to comment on somebody, your friend. Okay. And she has dressed up in some new dress, and you want. When what you are talking to yourself, it's not good. She's not looking good in this dress, or this color doesn't suit her. That is your self-talk. Okay. And what you do, your self-talk is equal to talk. Then you will tell her that it doesn't suit you. This color doesn't suit you. You are not looking good. This is one way of communication, right? Second way of communication is talk is not equal to self-talk. Means, in a mind, you are thinking, you are considering that she is not looking good. But while talking to her, you will tell her this color suits you. You are looking beautiful in this dress. Whereas you know that you are lying. Your opinion is not that. Your opinion is totally ulta. You are not. But your self-talk is not equal to talk. This is the second way of communication. There are two ways I have just explained. Which one is correct?
The one which you have
neither one said. Is correct. Neither one is correct because nothing will be acceptable. Neither first one nor second one, nothing will be acceptable. If you lie, you will not be able to give justice to yourself. If you lie, it will be not correct on your part. But if you tell her the truth, she will be unhappy. She will not feel good. That also is your loss. So what is the third way out? There is only one way out, which is to be adopted by every one of us, is self-talk should be equal to modified self-talk. You have to modify your self-talk and you have to talk.
Okay. Thank you.
Right? So this principle, you can use it in social media also. Means what? You can directly tell her that look, this is not that. It is comparatively that day what you are wearing was too good. Compared to that, this is not that great. Like that. You have to decide how you are going to modify your self-talk. Are you getting my point? So this is doesn't mean you are lying. You are telling the truth in a different manner. Maybe you have to work on your tone. You have to work on your content, like that. But you have to tell the truth only. Telling lies is not correct for good for the long-term relationship. It can work once, it can work twice, it cannot work in long-term. So you have to tell the truth. What you want to say, you have to say that only, but you maintain your tone, maintain your language, and try to modify it to some extent that it will not hurt the foreign person. That much we can do. And apart from all this, also if somebody is misunderstood your talk or maybe whatever you have written on the social media, then it is his choice. Right? Happiness is the choice, na? Ultimately. You have to choose. You have to choose to be happy. Nobody else can make you that.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
I hope I have answered to your question to some extent.
Oh, thank you, ma'am.
You have to be a little smarter or diplomatic, maybe.
Hello, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Good evening, ma'am.
Good evening.
Ma'am, actually, my question was a bit similar to what Preetal just asked. Okay. like whenever we nowadays everything is through social media and online, so mm-hmm. whenever we present ourselves or like get to know people through social media, there's like they get a perspective of us they are thinking, mm-hmm. and somewhat it doesn't matches what we are supposed to be presenting.
Mm.
So they get some wrong view about us, then how are we supposed to change that? And even if we try to explain them, they think that we would be like telling them to please them or make them feel nice about us like that.
See, again, answer is same. See, maintaining the tone, if front person is educated enough or if he is willing to understand, if he is willing to learn something, he will get right. involved.
Okay.
ऐसा है ना कि हम बोलते हैं ना कि जो सो रहा है उसको उठाया जा सकता है, पर जो सोने की एक्टिंग कर रहा है उसको आप नहीं उठा सकते.
राइट राइट
राइट बरोबर है ना.
यस मैम राइट.
हां, जो झोपला है त्याला आपण उठवू शकतो, जो झोपायची एक्टिंग करतोय त्याला तू उठवू शकतो का?
नाही मैम.
इट इज लाइक दैट. बट इफ यू वॉन्ट समबडी टू गेट कन्विन्स्ड, यू कैन यूज प्रॉपर लैंग्वेज, प्रॉपर कंटेंट, एंड यू हैव टू हैव द फैक्ट्स एंड फिगर्स. जस्ट यू कैन नॉट पुश योर पॉइंट लाइक दैट. इफ यू प्रूव इट विद समथिंग, this is what I am saying, it has got these many things in, you know, documentary evidence or some past experiences, that makes your case strong. You have to have real life examples, then only front person gets convinced fast. So bolte hi rahoge to aage ka ke to bolta hi rehta hai, kuch proof hai kya? So better you take it with you,
right?
And then you present.
Yes ma'am, thank you ma'am.
There is
one more question.
Yeah.
Anonymous person.
No problem.
Okay. How to improve decision making ability?
How to
improve decision making ability?
How to improve decision making ability?
Yes.
Okay. See, first of all, one must accept that there is no concept of wrong decision. There is no word like wrong decision. Do we take any decision as a wrong decision? चलो आज एक wrong decision ले लेता हूँ. हम ऐसे कभी सोचते हैं क्या? Any decision taken at any point of time is the best possible decision at that point of time. It may be, you know, it gets, it proves to be a non-quality decision in future. There is a concept called quality decision and non-quality decision, but there is no concept of wrong decision. First, take it out from your mind. There is no wrong decision concept. कभी भी हमें decision लेना है तो we always try to take a best possible decision, which is right decision at that point of time. With over the period, with the experience, it proves to be a wrong, non-quality decision to some extent, but that is okay. But how to improve it? It comes with the knowledge. It comes with the experience. No one can be a good decision maker immediately overnight. मैं एक बुक पढ़ता हूँ आज रात को और कल सुबह से decision making में ऐसा हो जाऊंगा. It will not happen anytime. Even if you become 60, 70, 80 years old, it will not happen. So it has to have the some experience. You have to have the good reading, sharing. You have to share your experiences with others. Then only, or maybe, you know, keep listening, share, ask, take feedbacks. Then your your database increases, and on that basis of database only you take the decision. No? Generally, my way of taking decision is, if I have to take a decision of, you know, buying something or addressing something or going someplace, I take views, I take feedbacks from the people, I involve people. Many of us are afraid of sharing our, you know, our agenda or our, what you want to do in life. They want to hide it from the people. They want to surprise people. And then they end up taking wrong decisions sometimes. So this is the first technique which I follow as a personally, that I discuss with the people. If I want to do something, if I want to buy a car, if I want to buy something, you know, I will keep discussing. What car you are using, which one you are using, how it is working, how much average it is. Keep talking to people. And even if I do not buy it, it's a myth. It's people feel like that. Then others will laugh at me. She was asking for the details and she didn't buy. Nobody has time and nobody is interested. You take the information from the others. That will help you to take the great or maybe, you know, quality decision. I'll not say correct or wrong. quality decision. Your decision will be quality decision only when it has got the feedbacks and views from others. Keep discussing. Don't hide. Don't hide. And speed of the decision comes with the experience only. You cannot expect a 20-year-old boy to take decision, you know, very fast compared to the other person having an experience of 30, 40 years. It will come with time. But for that, your eyes, ears need to open all the time.
True.
Hope I have answered your question.
And one more thing that I would like to add is how to improve decision capability to make bad decisions. That teaches us. I think somebody has kept mobile and laptop both on. तुमच्या कोणापैकी मोबाईल आणि लॅपटॉप दोन्ही ऑन आहे. ओके, सो टेकिंग बॅड डिसिजन्स प्रॉबेबली इज अ लर्निंग स्टेप टुवर्ड्स टेकिंग गुड डिसिजन्स मे बी. आय मीन, सो वेन वी गो रॉंग फ्रिक्वेंटली वी रिअलाइज दॅट वी नीड टू थिंक डिफरंटली अँड प्रॉबेबली दॅट्स द वे. आय मीन, दिस इज वन अदर आस्पेक्ट ऑफ इट. देर इज वन मोर क्वेश्चन बाय अगेन अन अनॉनिमस पर्सन. Before reading out the question, I feel what madam wanted to teach us, or what the development of soft skills is all about, it teaches us to develop skills for a live interaction, if I am not mistaken.
Right.
What
people, yes, sir, exactly.
What people asking, what questions asking, what question. Asking, they are revolving around
virtual
interaction. So it's not wrong. Madam can correct me. In a clinical situation, in our own clinic or in our own hospital, how to deal with people who are either our employers or who are our customers. So on both the sides, how to deal with these people to achieve professional success is the theme of this soft skills development, if I'm not wrong, madam. Okay, so let us go to the next question. थोड़ा सा प्रश्न मोटा है. Many a times we have to say no to people. Now, people who ask repeatedly for favors, I mean, मी त्याचा अर्धविराम मध्ये दिलेला, पण मी असा अर्थ घेतो त्याचा. मेनी टाइम्स वी हॅव टू से नो टू पीपल आस्किंग रिपीटेडली फॉर फेवर्स अँड वी आर सेईंग नो ड्यू टू आर कम्फर्ट इश्यूज. नाव दीज पीपल डिस्पाइट बीइंग काइंड, मेजॉरिटी ऑफ टाइम्स दिस वन नो विल पोर्ट्रे अ नेगेटिव इमेज इन देअर माइंड. सो वन नो despite of me being so kind majority of the times, this one time no makes or portrays a negative image of mine in their mind. How to deal with such things?
Ne pan repeated no hai ki one time no hai ha question
par repeated asking ahe ani one time no ahe asa diste mala ekandare. I requested the person to type name and so that he or she can voice her question so that we can answer it in a better manner.
Mala je kalla tyachyavarun I'll just try to answer this question like this, that in fact people say in a industry, in a trainings which I have gone through, saying no is a quality. Means learn to say no. It's a quality.
Yes,
you know, if somebody is misinterpreting or if he carrying a wrong image of yours, it is again his choice. See, you can have a cake too. It is just like that. Barabar hai na? You have the cake in front of you and you want to eat it also. Both the things cannot happen. It can be either it will be in your stomach or it will be for the decoration. Either one will happen at a time. Okay? And saying no, it depends that for which kind of favor you are saying no. Again, that I do not know. If it is in your reach, if you can really help the person, you help him. He'll be happy. Okay, but if you are, it is really not in a position to give any priority. So what difference does it make that if your he she is carrying wrong image of yours? Does it make any? Then you have to just work on it, that what is important, whether that relation is important or going out of comfort zone is important. If relation is important, then you have to go out of comfort zone and do it. If relation is not that important for you, then you have to be in your comfort zone and focus on your work. That is again a choice, na, finally. One has to choose it.
Yes.
And there are n number of choices you have to make at every stage of your life, to be frank with you.
Very true.
Am I right?
Absolutely.
You cannot have both the things. You cannot please everyone, first of all. And if you are convinced that I am not able to do this, I am saying no because there is some comfort issue of mine and I really cannot do it, cannot help it, then you have to just leave it like that. Then it is front person's choice whether to carry wrong image. And if you are your efforts are worth, or maybe true to yourself, then he will realize one day. That person will definitely realize one day, because he will also come across that again in future, if he is your subordinate or maybe he is your student, or maybe he will come to that level one day and he will also realize your problem one day. But saying no is not a it's not a what you say drawback, it's a quality.
There is one genuine question around here. How to be good at social interaction if you are an introvert?
Introvert, then you have to work on the introvert first, then go on social media. How it's linked? I am an extrovert person, but I am not on a social media. So it's a two different eras altogether.
He's not he or she, Ishwari.
Whatever.
She's not asking about social media usage. She is asking only about the overall social interaction. If you are in
overall social interaction, okay.
How to
then
be good
she has to, then she has to. We have already discussed various parameters. Like you have to open up, then choose your. See, you can start with the comfort zone. Just try to be open with your sister first. Try to be open with your mother. Then go to the friends like that. You can increase your reach of the people. You can go to some far extent later, right? But you have to practice. You have to practice. There is no other way of it. If you are introvert, you have to make. See, there is one concept actually, but now I don't know whether we have time to dark, blind, open and close. You have to find out what are your open areas. Open areas means what? Which others know about me. Huh? And I also know about me, which is an open area. I can sing well. I know others also know, like that. So you have to find out what are your open areas. Closed areas are there, like I know what I can do, but others do not know that I can do this. I am very good at singing, but nobody in the world knows that I can. I am good at singing. So how will I make them know that I am good at singing? So what will I do? Somewhere I will start. If there is a meeting or there is a get together happening or something like that, I will just say that, can I try one song? Or just try whispering or like that. Then people will understand. You have to make them understand. Your closed area, you have to make it open for the others. Then there is a blind area that I do not know what I can do, but others know I can do it. Just hearing me or people feel, you speak so, then I'll say, no, I cannot sing. Then somebody else will say, just try. I think you can. Or maybe you can good at teaching. Your voice is high pitch, or maybe you explain the things very much in detail. So I think you should go into teaching. But I am afraid of doing that because I do not know. That is a blind area. And then there is a dark area, like I do not know what I can do, and other also do not know what I can do. So what options I am left with? Just keep exploring. I do not know whether I can sing. Others also do not know I can sing. Then I can keep just trying. Singing or maybe swimming, dancing, something. I have to try. I have to join some classes. I have to see. So you have to work in that area. If the person is introvert, you have to see what are your open areas, what are your closed areas, what are your blind areas, and what are your dark areas. Work on that. Open area, you do not have to work anything. Try to be open in closed area. Hope I am clear. I don't know. This is a very, big concept, but I tried to put it in a one or two minutes. It's difficult.
That was really great response, huh?
Sorry?
That was really great reply, great response.
Students, I do not know. They must be finding it difficult to understand at this age. I can guess that. No.
I am sure they are intelligent enough, and much more than 20C, it seems that they are enjoying it because we are still getting questions. Although this question I don't find appropriate here on the platform teaching us about soft skills development, but still I would read out it for you. Due to some incidents in the past, people have a wrong image of a doctor. And they feel that doctors are just using the people in this pandemic. How to talk to such people?
Doctor, you only answer this question, I feel. It's beyond my reach. But my principle as a human being, whatever doctor I have preferred so far, my principle is to trust him. Whatever others say, let them say. Whatever doctor, whoever I am going to, I trust him fully. That is my way of looking at the doctor. But see, again, it's a world of different mentalities, different individuals. You really cannot control it, na? What I can say, that has to come from medical field itself. But I personally feel that a layman or maybe a common man like me, who is not non-medico person, let's put it like that, non-medico person, for him, because I'm getting this platform, I am just putting my thoughts, trying to share my thoughts, that for him, after God, if somebody is there, is a doctor. I'm serious. I'm really genuinely telling you that after God, if he's somebody he is looking up to, is the doctor. Because for him, doctor is like a God, and he expects everything. Because the God, he cannot see, he cannot talk to God. So he see only doctor. So he tried to expect everything from him. So you have to think from his point of view also, that what is his expectation, frustration level, right? If somebody dies for no reason in some hospital, you know the cases, then whom they have in front of them to blame? So they blame doctors. That doesn't mean that they really are against doctors or something like that, but it's a feeling. And nobody can challenge the feeling. Huh? That is another session itself. Nobody can challenge the feeling. If I am getting angry, I get angry. I cannot say, somebody cannot ask me why you got angry. Because anger is the feeling. Feelings can be discussed, and but feelings cannot be challenged. Feelings cannot be challenged. So it is his feeling as a patient, that he is feeling that it is just injustice is made to me or something like that. And you take it this way, that he cannot speak to God. That's why he is speaking to you. I don't know whether I have answered it correctly or not. Dr. Pustake, you can just...
I just want to add one thing. That due to some incidents in the past, bad incidents in the past, as we say, we know bad incidents about doctors, but I think these are applicable to all the fields. There are bad politicians, there are bad builders, there are bad teachers. So there are so many categories where we can find bad people. So if we keep on thinking about only opinion of people due to those bad people, I think it will be a waste of time. So our job should be to work honestly and ethically to the best of our abilities and justify our responsibilities. This would be the answer.
Work honestly. Yes.
Teachers
ko bhi to students se mara hai. Aise kitne cases hai? Past mein bhi hai, abhi bhi hai. Engineering students, architecture college students, they beat teachers. What not has happened with teachers also? It is not only medical profession where doctors are blamed. Means the employer is blamed, but it is happening many places. So what Dr. Pustake said, I am totally in agreement with him, that we should give our 100%.
There is one more question. Yeah. How to become less emotional, especially in front of people? Means getting teary eyes immediately when someone speaks harshly to you. Mm. It embarrassed me a lot many times. So,
who has asked this question?
Again, anonymous attendee.
But I would like to share that correct question to the wrong person, because I am sailing in the same boat. In fact, I am finding, I was trying to look for this answer. So to say, but yes, I had asked question to my senior at tough time, because I had this habit of, you know, getting tears in eyes immediately. I was very emotional. I was too much emotional. But then that senior or my plant head had told me, and I am trying to follow this. So you also try to follow that. Try to isolate yourself from the incidents. Whenever you are taking any decision or when something is happening around you, so try to isolate you from that particular thing. Like something bad thing is happening, or somebody is trying to scold somebody, or somebody is giving gali, or somebody is showing you your mistakes or talking to you with of your mistakes. So try to isolate. Don't take it too hard. So if you follow that, helps to some extent. It doesn't give 100% result, but definitely it reduces to some extent. And with age, it improves with age. But it's again, I'm telling you, getting sad or getting emotional is again a feeling. It is again a feeling. See, feelings cannot be challenged. It is born. It comes. You cannot really work on that to the extent we want. It can be worked to some level, some extent, but not 100%, not fully. So you want to cry, you cry for 5 minutes, get cheered up, and then put your points. What is the disadvantage of crying or getting tears into eyes? You cannot put your points forward when you are crying. And then you feel guilty after that because you could not speak. That is the drawback. Even I have suffered this, but then I try to isolate yourself from the incidents, from the people. Just forget that what is your relation with that person, and that comes with the experience and age. Maybe at this age it will not be possible for you, but generally the people who get involved, who are more sympathetic, who are very more empathetic, they face this problem. They always try to see themselves in others' place, and then they get emotional. So you have to stop doing that. That's the only solution, at least with those who are not relating to us. I can understand with your family member, you cannot do that. But outsiders, you can always practice this. Right?
Yes. So don't give too much of importance to others' opinions about you.
Yeah. It is easy to say, it is difficult to practice because I have experienced it. Question is rightly asked, but there is no theory or there is no what you say, just apply that logic and do it. It's not like that. It comes with the experience. But first stage you can do, isolate yourself from the incidents. Isolate means physical isolation. I'm not talking about physical isolation. Huh? Nowadays, isolation world has become so common that get locked in one bedroom. It is not like that.
Mental dissociation.
Let me clear. Isolate from emotional isolation, I am talking about. Emotional isolation, as if you are not part of the game at all. Just convince your mind with that thought that I am not part of it. I am not part of it. Whatever he is telling, it is not for me. I am not part of it. But again, everything has its own effects or consequence. Then you may lose some feedbacks. That's the bad part of that, bad side of it, disadvantage, drawback of it. Then people will stop telling you. That is also there. So you have to balance.
There is one more question. If a student wants to pursue career in foreign countries, what approach he or she should have in order to improve soft skills and communication skills? So I feel
approach.
Vaikari wants to know if there is any change in the approach if we wish to work in India and if we wish to work abroad as far as development of soft skills and communication skills are concerned.
No. Straight answer is no. There is no difference. Maybe there are some, some practices. Practices can be different, in India, and in like way back in 2005 we had been to London, and then we came to know there that wearing white shoes is not a good sign there. Here we wear boys, specifically boys I'm talking about. Boys wear white shoes here in India, but there some of our friends told us that don't bring white shoes because wearing white shoes here in London is considered a wrong practice. So like practices can differ, but the way we talk, politeness, it will not change, na? Why should it will be? And wherever your country, whichever country you are planning to visit, you can get the details. Now you are technically so much ahead, you get everything on the internet and Google and all. So you can always get the information, but other soft skill parameters will not change. Then there are some practices like here we get involved, like just now I was telling isolate yourself. We get involved in other people's problem. If somebody, one of our friends is crying, we are interested to know why is she crying, what happened to her at her house, who did what to her. We are interested, but in some of the countries, it is again considered bad manners. They don't like, they tell you don't be nosy. Matlab kya? Aapka isme tumcha naak ghalu naka hyachyamadhye. Asa. It is like that. So it is, the practices can be different. That can be learned now when you go to that. But basic strategy will not differ. Why should? It is all good parts, good things we are learning. No. Why will it change? In fact, it will be respected. Right? Dale Prashna, some play?
Dale, this time, sir. रियली गुड इन्फॉर्मेटिव आणि मला वाटतं म्हणजे वी कुड सी पीपल गेटिंग मोर अँड मोर इंटरेस्टेड इन टू इट.
झाले प्रश्न नसतील तर
प्रश्न आपण आता थांबूया.
ओके बिफोर वी स्टॉप
अनुराधाच चालू झालं.
हा
तू अनम्यूट झाली. वन्स यू आर देर इज समॉब्लम स्पीक नो इश्यूज. ठीक आहे. If there are no questions, we will wind up the session.
Yeah. But before we wind up, I want to thank everyone of you. KBH College, Pustake, Dr. Pustake, Dr. Anuradha, the participants for the patient listening. This was my first session with doctor. So I was a little bit nervous when I was asked to give this session because I was not aware that what expectations doctors will have. But I am happy with the session because questions what came is like any other colleges, they come up with the same type of questions. And I hope that I have clarified, I could clarify some of them. So thank you very much and hope to
yes, ma'am.
See you.
We also enjoyed a lot. On behalf of Mahatma Gandhi Vidya Mandir's KBH Dental College, we thank you for sparing so much of time and delivering such a wonderful session for all our students.
It was a pleasure.
It will be an eye-opener, and I hope the students will keep in touch with you if they have any problems related to the soft skills and communication skills.
Yeah, you can share my mobile number with the students if they want.
Yes. So thanks again.
Thank you.
This session.
Stop.
Yes.